Hello friends, I'll explain you a method of relative strength analysis in this video. It's an interesting method of picking the stocks. The way we analyze price charts, we can also analyze ratios of different instruments to get the idea about what is happening in the markets. Let me first explain you ratio chart. If we divide price of one instrument by price of another and if we multiply it by 100, we get ratio. So for example, if price of Bank Nifty is 20,000 and Nifty 10,000, and if I divide Bank Nifty by Nifty and multiply by 100, I get ratio 200. So this way we can calculate ratio of two instruments on daily basis and connect them and draw ratio chart. So this, it looks like a line chart, but it is a ratio of two instruments. Here price level is not important, trend of ratio is important. This is a ratio chart of Bank Nifty divided by Nifty. So numerator is Bank Nifty and denominator is Nifty. Rising ratio line indicates that numerator is outperforming denominator, and falling ratio line indicates that numerator is underperforming denominator. So in this case, here Bank Nifty is outperforming Nifty and here it is underperforming Nifty. So this way, if we plot price of all sector indices against Nifty, then we can get to know about sectors that are outperforming and underperforming by analyzing trend of ratio charts. There is another interesting method. Now for example, this A, B, C, D, E and F are sectors. We can build this type of table if we divide price of each sector by price of every other sector. So this side is numerator and this is denominator. So here it is B divided by A. It shows bullish because ratio is bullish. This is B divided by C. Here ratio is bearish. We call this ultimate matrix. See this. This is the matrix of all sectors. Here price of every sector is divided by every other sector. So this left side is numerator and this is denominator. When the ratio is bullish, the score is 1 or the box is green. When ratio is bearish, the score is 0 or box is red. To decide bullish or bearish ratio, we look at point and figure charts because they are swing charts and only take price into account. So if ratio of two instruments is in column of X, meaning it is rising, the score is 1. If it is in bearish column, then score is 0. If we'll click on any box, then point and figure ratio chart of those two instruments will appear. You can analyze that. If you can click on any name and analyze the price chart. Now here at the right hand side, you get total score. So you get to know that a sector is outperforming how many other sectors. If you sort this, you get to know which sectors are outperforming or underperforming most of the other sectors, not only Nifty. And you can analyze place of Nifty here. Sectors which are above Nifty are outperforming and below Nifty are underperforming. If market is bullish, then outperforming sectors should be more than underperforming sectors, right? And if market is bearish, most of the sectors will be underperforming. You can count number of bullish and bearish sectors and you can get the idea about strength or weakness of the market. We can also do same thing with stocks of particular group or sector to find out relatively strong or weak stocks. For example, if you are bullish on metal index, you can plot a matrix of metal index. So here price of every stock of metal index is divided by price of every other stock of the same index. You get to know which stocks are outperforming or underperforming the overall space. So this is relative strength analysis of stocks of a particular sector or group. So this is about ultimate matrix. Now coming back to relative strength. For better RS analysis, the analysis of denominator is a key aspect. So when we are analyzing sectors, trend of Nifty is important to keep in mind. So when Nifty is in uptrend, we should look at outperforming sectors, and when Nifty is in downtrend, we should trade underperforming sectors. So when Nifty is bullish, the reward is more in trading continuation patterns of outperforming stocks. And keep in mind the sectors which are underperforming, you can trade them if Nifty weakens and they continue to underperform. This is an important reading about relative strength. Same way, when Nifty is bearish, trade underperformers and keep in mind the outperformers. During the corrective phase, it is very important to analyze the sectors which are changing. So for example, if market is bullish and there is correction which is happening, look at the sectors those are outperforming and underperforming during this corrective phase. If you get another breakout and trend resumes after the correction, then trade the sectors that remain strong during the corrective phases, because they should typically lead in this leg of breakout. You might get very strong chart patterns in the stocks of those leading sectors. If that correction turns out to be deep and markets keep falling, then you can short those underperformers because they will typically fall more. Same way, keep in mind outperforming and underperforming stocks when there is corrective rally in downtrend. So this analysis of outperformers or underperformers during corrective moves can give you idea about sectors and stocks to trade in the next leg. They will typically be the leaders. This reading is applicable to all time frames, right from long term to intraday charts. So if you are a short term trader and you find market bullish in the morning, then focus on outperforming sectors and look at what is happening during corrective trends. So the idea is to find out outperforming or underperforming sectors first, above Nifty, below Nifty. Then find the strong RS stocks and then perform price analysis on them. See which stocks from them you find attractive on price charts, levels to enter, exit, risk reward, etc. When you see a price breakout of a stock, there is a micro level story. But when entire space is moving, you get to know that something is happening at the macro level, and breakout can work really well during such times. You get to trade leading stocks which are in momentum. So if particular sector has given a price breakout and if you find it also outperforming, then the performance is expected to remain continue, and you can get the idea which stock should be traded for continuation patterns. I believe in up move or down move, trading continuation patterns in the leading stocks is a very rewarding trading setup. Also, keep in mind the new entrants that are coming up in outperformer or underperformers list. To give you an example, if metal is outperforming and then I suddenly see FMCG coming up in the outperformers list, and if it is remaining there, I should look at price charts of FMCG sector stocks. I might get to trade leaders of the next leg. So to begin with, study this top-down approach. Keep in mind analysis of denominator and focus on new entrants that are coming. Relative strength coupled with price analysis can make a good setup. There are many other aspects of relative strength analysis. I'll record more videos on this. Let me know about your queries and suggestions. Thank you for watching this video.